So, dear students, now we will be discussing the concept of cross elasticity of demand. Now, we have learned in our previous topic that the demand for a commodity is not only affected by the change in its own price, but also by the prices of related goods. And you know that the related goods may be either a substitute good or a complementary good. So any change in price of a substitute good or a complementary good may affect or will have an effect on the demand for a particular commodity. So cross elasticity of demand refers to the degree of responsiveness of quantity demanded of any one commodity in response to a change in the price of another commodity. That means if the price of say Y increases, the percentage change that will be brought about in the demand for commodity X will represent its cross elasticity of demand. Now suppose if X and Y are substitutes for one another, let us take it in other manner. That first of all we discuss that cross elasticity of demand EC is represented by percentage change in quantity demanded of X divided by percentage change in price of Y, where X and Y are two related goods. So this can be rewritten as change in quantity demanded of commodity X by initial quantity demanded of X into 100. That gives you the percentage change in quantity demanded of X divided by percentage change in price of Y, that is equal to change in price of Y by initial price of Y into 100. This gives you percentage change in price of Y. So this can be rewritten as delta QX by QX into PY by delta PY, or delta QX by delta PY into PY by QX gives you what? Gives you cross elasticity of demand. Now you must remember that there can be three kinds of cross elasticity of demand. Number one, remember, in case of substitute goods, positive cross elasticity of demand applies. That means why? Because say X and Y are two related goods which are substitutes for one another. Now as a result of rising price of Y, if the demand for X increases, there exists a positive relationship between the two. So therefore, the cross elasticity of demand will be positive. Say, with the rising price of tea, the demand for coffee increases. Why? Because when the price of tea rises, tea becomes relatively costlier to coffee. As a result, people prefer to have more of coffee instead of tea. That means with the rising price of tea, demand for coffee increases. So there exists a positive relationship between the two. So therefore, it has a positive cross elasticity of demand. Now, we are coming to complementary goods. I have discussed previously that complementary goods are those goods which are jointly demanded to satisfy a particular want, and one cannot be put to use unless the other one is available. Say for example, we had discussed previously pen and refill. They are demanded together to satisfy a particular one, and one cannot be put to use unless the other one is available. Now in case of complementary goods, there exists an inverse relationship between price of pen and the demand for refill. So in this case, negative cross elasticity of demand applies, because with the change in price of Y, the demand for X will fall. So therefore, the cross elasticity of demand will be negative. Now remember, in case of unrelated goods, unrelated means there does not exist any sort of relationship between the commodities concerned. Say the price of petrol and demand for umbrella. They are unrelated goods, so the changes in price of petrol will in no way affect the demand for umbrella.